Welcome back to the Horror Shed Podcast. I'm one of your hosts, Jared. Down here, we have South Jersey Jason. Brian, how the hell are you doing this week?
I'm doing good. I'm running on E right now, but it's Friday.
That it is. It is Friday. Yes.
It's Friday. And for all you Gypsy Rose fans out there, there's a new 2020 doc and interview they're doing with her tonight. I think she's digging her own grave. You know, a lot of her fans are turning against her, so it's only a matter. The newest one was, I was watching when she was younger and the mom was controlling her, and the mom wanted her to shut up when she was talking. The mom would like squeeze her wrist. Well, and then one of the interviews that she was doing with her husband, he was talking, and you see her go like that to him. Yep. But I love the people impersonating her voice, because so there's like an interview and she's got that squeaky Mickey Mouse voice. So that's like the that's showing up on my TikTok videos now. It's like, you can't stop me, I'm on fire. But yeah, you know, I was looking, there really hasn't been a lot of news in the horror front lately, but the one I did see earlier on Bloody Disgusting, and I did hear about this a while ago, there's a stage production of The Lost Boys coming out.
I did see that.
Yes, I don't know if it's going to be Broadway or off-Broadway, but our favorite actor who portrays Ed Warren is producing it.
Oh.
Yeah, Patrick Wilson's producing it. Did you watch the trailer for the Broadway or the play where they put the VCR in?
No.
The tape in? Yeah, I'll share it too. It looks pretty cool. It just says Santa Clara 87, and then it just has the titles of who is producing and doing the music and whatnot. And then you hear whoever is watching the video get attacked by someone, and the tape pops out, Lost Boys the musical, with blood dripping down. It was really cool.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
That could be fun.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I love the Back to the Future musical. I was real skeptical going in. And if they can make a DeLorean fly in Broadway, you can see some flying vampires.
Or at least hanging off a bridge.
Yeah, yeah. The only thing I watched this week was just the latest episode of True Detective, which is really good. Have you watched the other seasons?
I've watched one and two. I don't think I made it through three. Wait. How many seasons are there?
This is the fourth season.
Yeah, I never made it through three.
Three was kind of boring. I mean, I like the lead actor. I forget
who
the guy
was
who. It was a black guy. I forget his name. I think it's the guy that's slated to play Blade whenever that comes out.
Who was the second season?
Second season had Colin Farrell.
Yeah, that was okay.
Yeah, yeah. This one has Jodie Foster, and like she's a sheriff that nobody likes. And, you know, basically, it's think of 30 Days a Night without the vampires, but there's something going on where the scientists all disappeared from the center and they were found frozen out in like the tundra or whatever, all naked, but their clothes all nicely folded, and something to do with like a spiral design that's related to an unsolved murder from a few years prior.
The Russians.
It's really good. It's really good.
I'm blaming the Russians.
Yeah, and then of course non-horror related, I finished Ted. Ted, two thumbs up.
Oh yeah, that shit was so funny, nonstop. Yeah. But even it had like a family value to it too, like which made it even funnier.
I forget the actor's name, but he was the son in Critters, plays a dad. Oh, is he great? And with the toy truck.
Oh, yeah, that shows. I want seven more, Seth. Come on, get your ass back in there to the Fox, and let's keep pumping these out, because you got a winner.
Yeah, it was really good. I mean, only eight episodes. It just went by so quick.
I know. Dude, we cleared it out in one day. We really did. We just kept fucking, this is awesome. We're going to keep watching this.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, Ted was classic. I gotta watch Chucky. That's on the. We're watching Peaky Blinders right now.
Never watched that. Is it good?
Very good.
Is it okay? Yeah, Chucky should be resuming the current season soon, I
Oh,
think.
cool.
Yeah, are you so you didn't start like season two or three?
Three. I haven't started three yet.
The current one that I think it
Yeah.
is, yeah. So far it's I mean three is to me is the episodes are flowing really good. Like I felt like the previous two seasons, like last season, the episodes kind of were slow paced up until like the Christmas episode. These episodes go by really quick, so it's got a good pacing to it.
Oh, cool. I have to check that out.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. What I watch? I'm almost done Weeds. We finished Ted. Been watching Peaky Blinders. Great show. It can get a little stale at times, but I mean, Tom Hardy, he's not a big cast member in it, but he's fucking awesome in
Oh,
it.
he's in, I didn't know he was in
Oh
Peaky
yeah.
Blinders.
He's in a couple episodes, and but I mean, the main dude, he's been phenomenal since 28 Days Later. So
Yeah.
I'm not surprised by him. And then the two other brothers are fucking fantastic. It's a really good show.
Really
Not
good.
like watching, London mobsters run amok.
Nice. There's also a trailer. Now, it's not horror because when I saw Jordan Peele was producing it, I was like, it's think of an Indian Jason Statham. That's the best way I can describe it. It is I'll send you the trailer. It is called Monkey Man.
Monkey Man.
At first I'm like, is this like India's version of Black Panther? Because it talks about how like there was a guy that was like the city's protector or something, and he puts on a monkey mask, but it's far from it. It's like an Indian Jason Statham meets John Wick. Like it's yeah, he reminds me of Jason. Well, pretty good movie, like Indian Keanu Reeves and John Wick, but it looks really good. I'll send you the trailer.
All right.
Yeah.
That sounds different.
All
Yeah,
right. So
Oppenheimer comes out on
again.
Peacock.
Oh, and Peacock. Well,
Yeah.
they're releasing in the theaters.
Are they?
Yeah, because it's Oscar time.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you think? Okay, because obviously that got nominated for 13 Oscars, which it should. Okay, so now I'm gonna let out a little secret. I wanted to see what all the hoopla was about Barbie. So I did start watching it, but I started it late at night and
Yeah, you
obviously
started
home.
at 8 o'clock and
That's pretty much it. So, okay, so basically it's a feminist movie, right? We all know that.
oh yeah, we're being
Nothing
told.
against that. How is it that Ryan Gosling got nominated but Greta Gerwig didn't? Robbie Morgan didn't get nominated? Like, do you think that's like a giant FU to the
It
female
is.
actresses?
It's it, I don't
Yeah.
know if it's a few to females, but Hollywood will do whatever they want to do. They're pissed off that non-artsy movie made all that fucking money, so they're taking it out on them.
Yeah.
Because if you look at them, the only person that does those artsy-fartsy bullshit movies is that blonde douchebag.
Yeah. Who, Ryan Gosling?
Yeah, I can't stand
You
him.
know, I like Ryan Gosling.
Yeah. He
I
was a
like
complete
him.
liability at corner in the Denzel movie with the football.
Oh, I
Remember
know
the
him. I
Titans?
yeah, but he was also good in that movie where he played like the murderer with Sandra Bullock. Remember that?
No.
Where Oh, it was like his first movie, and they started dating. It was him and this other kid, like, wanted to be serial killers. So they targeted a family and, like, basically were going by a playbook of how to, like, cover up the scene and everything so they wouldn't find out. I have to go back and get you the title, but that was like one of his very first movies in like the late 90s, early
Huh,
2000s.
I'll have to check it out.
Yeah,
I just
yeah.
remember that he was a shitty corner and remember the Titans and
Oh, come on. And plus, he was in a notebook. I cry every time.
so every time, meaning you've watched it more than once.
I've watched it a few times. No more than,
Oh,
like,
come
I can
on.
count on my hand. Hey, I'm a softie, too.
Apparently, what do you get your fucking candies and lay under a cover with your hot chocolate while it's
My,
raining
no,
and watch a
no, it's
fucking notebook?
my, no, I eat, a pint of ice cream and cry.
Oh.
On other news, we'll switch from that. It was kind of funny though. Like, I loved how, I guess there's Barbie Land, and then they go into the real world. But it was just funny how they were playing like Barbies, where they walked on their toes, is that's how like their feet are, you know? But then when she started like becoming human, her feet went like that, and they were all going, But then you have what's the kid's name from Superbad? Michael
Sarah?
Thera. He plays a non-Ken doll that only had like one run, and he was so boring. It was funny how they had him in there.
I'll watch it eventually because I hear it's funny.
I'm sure it is funny. I mean, like I said, I dozed off within like a half
Yeah,
an
the
hour.
credits started and you're.
Pretty much. Well, I dozed off when they got into the reality
Okay.
world, and they were in that hot fluorescent rollerblading outfit that we've seen pictures of.
Yeah.
In non-Barbie related news, I got invited. So my friend Mark Hills, who helped me like when I first started with doing pictures and stuff, he wants to do more like events, and he has his own like it's called Spark Novelty Incorporated. So he's doing events for cosplayers, like getting them out to events and whatnot. So, and he also came out to a couple of the Friday 13th events at Blairstown I've had, like doing photography and stuff. But he said, hey, there's a convention. It's called Itzacon, Lehigh Valley Itzacon. It's actually in Bethlehem, and it's like a cosplaying convention, like pop culture convention, and it's all types of different cosplayers, like different, mediums. And they said if you want to come out, they want to promote you as a featured cosplayer. So I get a free table and everything. So it's the weekend of March 16th and 17th, but I'm only going to do the March 16th. So we'll be out there, promoting my brand. I'll promote our podcast, and I'm raising money. I'm gonna have a little donation box for a kiddies place, the cat rescue I did the Santa Claus photos for
Okay.
back in December. Yeah, so if you're in the Lehigh Valley area, come check me out March 16th, and it's from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. And I'll post it on our page once they like announce me and stuff. And then I believe I'll be coming back to South Jersey May 4th. I think I
Yep.
talked to for a free comic book day. And that's pretty much it. And then obviously I got NJ Horror Con coming up the end of April, towards the end of April. I'm excited for that. They just announced Adam Green, who was the director of Hatchet. And hey, your boys, did you see who else is gonna be there? They announced yesterday your favorite YouTubers.
Oh, the grim life, yeah.
Yeah.
So you get a signed wedding picture from them?
Yeah. No, they're gonna have more pictures, I think, this time.
Oh, cool.
They were
What the
working on
fuck?
that. Now, you shared with me you're going to a haunt next month,
We
right?
were invited out to Laurel's House of Horrors in
In
Maryland.
Maryland. Yeah,
It
awesome.
takes place in an old school movie theater. Well, not old school, like 80s.
That's cool. In a
Yeah.
movie theater. Okay, awesome. I bet that might have some maybe some bumps that go on in the middle of the night, and then we're going to be talking about that.
Yeah, we are. We're gonna get into ghosts, a little deep look into what we think, how people think, what we think they are, yada yada yada. But before I do that, you also have I Heart Horror coming up.
Oh, yes. I'm
I
sorry. I forgot
talked
to.
to Carnage, who will be joining you there last
Oh,
night,
yeah.
so that'll
Nice.
be fun.
He's the one with the chicken that he
Yep,
wants or something.
he's got
Yeah,
the big chicken.
okay. Is that pretty bad that that's what I remember
No,
him
that's what
from?
Terry remembered too.
Okay, nice.
She's like, ask him about the chicken. I'm like, you're sitting right here. Ask
Yeah, that's awesome.
him.
Yeah, I totally forgot. I am so sorry about that. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. That's from 11. It says 11 to 6, but it could go on later. It's $15 cash entry. There's no ticket, like pre-sales. A lot of great vendors are gonna have who I'm looking forward to meet, Patty Mullen from Frankenhooker. Wanna party? So that should be fun, and I'll network with her and see if we can get her on the show, because I had did when we had first started our podcast, I had messaged her a long time ago because she's pretty much active on Facebook, but I get, when you're a celebrity, sometimes don't see all the messages you get. So
I know. I don't see them all either. I mean, it's tough out there.
yeah, Yeah, so that should be fun, and that's in Sayreville. And actually, you know who's playing right across the street
Where's
on
that?
that day? Seven Dust.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Oh, so the Starland Ballroom's right across the street. Oh, that's cool. I've been to a couple shows there. It's a really small place, but
It
it's.
is. I always thought it'd be bigger than what it was when I saw it. I'm
Nah.
like, oh, that's small. It's
But
like,
you get fucking close, so it's pretty awesome.
that's cool. Yeah, that's cool.
I went to see Stain there.
Oh, nice. When Same was big, right?
Yeah.
Or before they got big, or
No, right
the...
about the time they were big.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, it was a good show.
Nice. That's awesome.
Love Aaron Lewis. That voice is
Yeah,
awesome.
he's great. Yeah.
All right, so yeah. All right, you got any grind your gears before we go on? Because I have a couple.
No, not really. I mean, not that grabs my gear, but you know what I am watching real close is this Vince McMahon sex trafficking, and now Brock Lesnar's brought into it. Oh man, this shit's gonna hit the fan. I can't wait to see the outcome. And I read the text messages they were posted on, they were leaked on Reddit. Holy crap, he's like a 77-year-old man, and the stuff that he wrote made me cringe.
Wow.
Yeah. But no grinds in my gears.
Fucking money, man.
Yeah.
I got one with UPS. Fuck you,
No.
UPS.
They
Because
expecting a
I
package.
had to go down to Virginia. So I spent 6 hours driving down there Monday. So Tuesday I went to the office. Found out that what we thought was broken wasn't broken, but I needed another part. So I stayed another night waiting for this part to get there, and it just never updated. So I waited till noon, drove all the way to fuck home. So now I'm gonna go back Monday because UPS dropped the ball.
You gotta go to Virginia? Okay. Oh gosh.
Thank you, UPS.
Damn UPS.
Yep. And the fucking 18-wheelers out there, like, I don't understand. I don't know why it takes you 4 months to get up to the fucking speed limit.
Oh, if you're going uphill, maybe that could be the
And
wise
not
road pill.
uphill, just normal
Oh,
fucking
okay.
roads, 4 hours. Like, I understand you're paid by the mile, but let's fucking speed it up here.
Oh yeah.
Then, dude, it's just been, my back is fucking killing me from sitting in the car. So, just getting closer and closer to being done with this shove fucking job. If you're hiring out there, hook a brother up. All right, so we don't have any research for this episode. We're probably just gonna freestyle this, and this is something I thought about sitting in the car for hours this week. So I'm gonna ask you simply, Brian, do you believe in ghosts?
Absolutely, I do.
100%. Okay.
I always, growing up, I always wanted to believe, but I wanted to experience something. So when I lived, this was going back 2006, 2007, I remember I was in my bedroom, and the door to that would go lead to the living room was like right on like the right hand side of me, so it's in my peripheral view. And the old the tube TVs, when you would turn them off, there might be a little flash. I was in my room with the lights off watching TV, and I did see the light like do that. I was like, what the hell? And so I was like, that's odd. And when I would go to bed, I was think I would hear people talking, so I'm like, let me put out a recorder. Like I had the old camcorder, so I just had it facing the living room. Didn't catch anything, but you could faintly hear something talking. It was like two different things, like having a conversation. I didn't have the TV on or anything, so that was my first experience. My second, it wasn't a firsthand experience, but my mom went to go see a medium back maybe a couple of years after that. So this is probably about 2006, 2007. My grandmom had passed away in 2004, and my aunt had passed away a year later before that. My mom's the only surviving child out of the family. Like my grandpa passed away when she was 12. So she kind of like wanted to get closure because she always felt a presence. So she went to the medium, and he's renowned. Like, he's got like published photos of quote unquote angels, so he's funny because he's located at a vetner, but he looks like a biker, so when you think of a medium, you think of like a woman, like the Long Island medium or whatever. But he was talking to my grandmom, and for some reason she would visit me, not like when I was like in my room or anything, but like when I was driving. And this is when I worked for the brain injury facility, and I had to go from like Egg Harbor Township up to up 30 to like Deptford or whatever, and I would pass through Hemonton. So he's like, as he's talking to my grandmom, she's like showing me blueberries, ask him what that means. Well, two things happened that day. Before I left to go to Deptford, I had a blueberry muffin, and as you're driving through Hamilton, the sign you usually see is Blueberry Capital of the World. And I was just like, why would she want to visit me? Because she was mean to me when she was alive, like when I was younger, I'm like, that's just very odd that she wanted to visit me. But yeah, those are like the two main things. And then more things are coming to my mind. I'm rambling on, but when I was 17, we went up to Bordentown because supposedly there's this area section, like, the tall tales of, of hearing things in the woods and whatnot. And we were on this dirt path, and there was a cornfield on your right and a field on your left. And we heard someone scream, "Help me," like over and over. And when we would call out, we wouldn't get a response. But I would say about a football field's length away from us, I saw two orange lights kind of just go like this and then come together and then come towards us. I was like, yep, we're getting out of here. So yeah, I believe.
All right. Yeah, it's just like I'm at the point where, like, I believe, I know they're there. I've seen them, I've smelt them, I've dealt with them. I dealt with that for 5 years. I know they're there. But, like, when other people say it, I just never believe them. Like, all these fucking shows I can't stand because they're all fakes. And I was listening to, I don't know what podcast, Lights Out maybe, and they had a bunch of YouTubers going into, like, this London castle. And yeah, a lot of fucked up shit happened at this castle.
Is it the Tower of London or just a castle?
No, it's a different cat. I think this might be more Scotland. It might have been, yeah, I think it was Scotland. And then, like, they're using this program that beeps when there's a ghost around and then it types shit. Yeah, because you can't program that. Like, watch, here we go. Oh, hi, Shelly, how are you? Look.
Oh, is Shelley on now?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I didn't I think I got on
Look,
YouTube.
I just programmed my computer to say there's a ghost in the chat. You know what I mean? Like, that shit bothers the hell out of me.
What up, homesies? Okay, I thought you said homeless. Oh, and I got another ghost story when you're done, so.
Yeah, so that just brought up this point. I'm like, and then I have, religious friends who don't believe in ghosts, but you pray to a ghost. Like, the contradiction between
Are you
the
praying to Ted, though? Remember, he thought he was Jesus.
and the fucking and the sons going along with it. He's like, maybe you are Jesus. All right, go for your next one.
Okay, so went to Gettysburg, gosh, like 11 years ago. It was actually the year before the 150th anniversary of the Civil War. Anyway, it was after Labor Day, so the ghost tour wasn't busy because everyone's in school. So we had like maybe like 12 people in our tour, and they alternate with either the Jenny Wade House or the orphanage right across the street. So we were at the orphanage, and so towards the end of the tour, when you're down in the basement, they'll give you time to like take photos and see if you can pick anything up. So they have a table with toys on there for the kids to play with. And so I was taking pictures, and then of course, it was back in the day when you still had like your regular digital camera, and I'm looking at it and I'm like, holy shit, I see feet. Like, you could see the and obviously were kids' feet, and they were wearing knickers. You can make out the shorts and everything. And then right above, I can make out a female neckline collar with, like, you know how the women would wear, like, I don't know what it would be, like right under the collar. I don't know what it would, it's like a oval shaped thing, you know.
Like a brooch, I
I
think they're called.
made it out. I was like, I was showing people because there were some people with EVP monitors and stuff. So when they went over to the table, their little thing spiked up, which was pretty cool. Because it's active, you know, it has been verified to be active. Yeah, but those are my experiences I can remember offhand right now. But yeah, you know, there's I want to be a part of a true, like if I knew someone that did investigations and they were legit, I would love to partake to experience that. You know, would I could be creeped out? Probably, you
Really?
know.
Why though?
It's the things you don't see that frighten
But it
me. Like,
can't
because
hurt you.
it can't hurt you. I know it can't. Well, they could possess, like, they could come home with me.
Okay, then it just got shit moving around in the house. It's not like.
Yeah. It's the things that don't see you that creep me out.
Okay.
You know, like being like possession movies, because that shit could happen.
Well,
And that creeps,
if
like,
Ed Warren ran the world, they'd all be demons. There'd be more
oh,
demons than humans.
speaking of Ed Warren, it's funny you brought that up. I came on my TikTok feed and it was Tony Sparrow and what I think was his son. I don't know if it was his son or someone else, but they take Annabelle out every so
Oh,
often
yeah,
and like bless,
to
yeah.
secure the case.
Yes. So I was watching that and the comments that I read, people were like, and these were comments that people don't know, like, oh, they're in it just for the money. Well, Tony Sparrow is, but they were also saying Judy, but you don't hear from
You don't
Judy.
hear shit about Judy.
No. It's like those uneducated fools that piss me off. And I wanted to say something, but you know what? I learned not to say
There's
anything.
no
It's
point.
no.
I
But
was in
and for
a
the
Call of Duty group today, and someone posted because you choose your loadout, what you go into war
yeah.
with, and people, there's so many different combinations you can do, so it's kind of fun to watch. But some guy goes, "Oh, this game sucks." So you join the game you don't like's little party to comment that this game sucks. Like, this is
Right.
what you're doing with your life? You're that much of a troll that you hate this game, but you had to comment on this post.
Yeah.
Ugh, fucking so tired of it.
Yeah, so excuse me. Yeah, so I would that's just the stuff that, like I said, I can't see creeps me out.
Okay.
And but I would love to be a part of a ghost hunt just to
I
partake
would
and
want to start a group that did it for real and not fucking YouTube views or to
Oh
build a museum
yeah.
or.
Yep. Nope. Yeah, I would love to, I would if I had the time, you know,
See, the
I
hard
would
part for me is I'll never be able to do it because I don't believe the tools that they're using.
Right.
Like, who the fuck said that an EMF field means ghost? Like, why would
Right.
they mean ghost? Maybe they were born before electricity, so how would there be a magnetic field? Like,
Right.
it doesn't make
Yeah.
sense. A lot of the shit they do doesn't make sense. Until I see it
Yeah.
with my actual fucking eyes, which I have, so I do believe in ghosts. Like, all these shows, like, the stupid, like, when they were using the Kinect to look for
Yes,
spirits,
Ghost Adventures,
it's
yeah.
programmed to find a body. So if it
Yeah.
sees, like, the outline of a door, it makes it a
Yeah.
body. That's what it's designed to fucking do. Stop.
Yeah. Yep.
And the EVP, I've heard some that were a little convincing, but even I have one that's convincing. But how do I know that wasn't someone in the background? How do I know that someone didn't speak with the. See, I can do that too. Look at
You know
that.
what I think brought the ghost hunting to people to start getting the shows, and it happened around the same time. Do you remember the Michael Keaton movie White Noise?
Yes.
That came out 2004,
Yeah.
I
It was a
think.
good
And then
movie.
it was a great movie, yeah. And then shortly after that, we started getting ghost
Yeah.
hunters and everything else. And like you said, we're in 2024 now with these night visions. Why are they still grainy?
Right. Why am I still watching your ghost hunt through a fucking potato when you make millions of dollars? Like, come on now. Give me a break. I want someone to set up a real fucking camera so we can actually see what the hell's going on. And, you know, you don't need night vision on your camera. You don't. You really don't. Cameras these days, my iPhone does fucking great in very little light. So you're telling me the real DSLR is having a hard time? You know, like it's so phony, a lot of it. And like even the ones I'm seeing pop up on TikTok, where like it's the streamer and you see the doors and shit move behind them. Those are pretty entertaining. I know they're fake, but it's pretty funny watching them act.
You know, and another thing, like, I feel like we don't get enough haunting, new hauntings anymore. Like, what
Right.
happened?
Why'd they die in the 80s? Why is there new properties haunted? And I think
I
I had
guess.
this conversation like with Shelly. I'm like, well, because Laurel's House of Horror does a ghost hunt. All right. Why is the theater haunted? Like, how did the spirits get there? And then I'm told they cling on to their past memories, but how do they get from point A to point B if they're stuck in
And you know,
houses
it's funny that
forever?
you say that because it's funny that you say that because I'm listen I one of the podcasts I listen to on occasion is Hollywood Crime Scene. Was it Hollywood Crime Scene? Yeah, and they were talking about hauntings in LA because I'm catching up and it was for October. And they had mentioned the Wolf Lodge, like out west. And Clark Gable would often go there. And he was cheating on his wife with another Hollywood actress who I think was flying out there and was killed in a plane crash. And they, Ghost Adventures, Zach was out there and picked up who he claimed was Clark Gable because he would stay there. But he didn't die there, you know?
Who was the chick from Wizard of Oz?
Garland.
Judy Garland. All right. You remember those little books that came out in the 90s about like haunted New Jersey? Like
Oh,
haunted Atlantic City, haunted this, haunted that. Well, it
yeah.
was said that Judy Garland haunted the Claridge, or the building that was the Claridge.
Did she even
Did Judy
was
Garland
it?
ever go to Atlantic City?
No, she died before the casinos were even built.
Right. Well, the
Yes.
Claridge is actually from the times of Boardwalk Empire.
Oh,
The
really?
building left of the Claridge, yeah.
Oh, okay.
So Shelley says, I am big, huge on the communication through radios. I have several, and I've never stopped being fascinated. But how do you know it's not feedback? How do you know it's not picking up another conversation? Radios scare me even more. And how does a ghost from the 1600s know how to communicate with a fucking radio? They don't know what that is.
Yeah, Irene chimed in and texted me Blair Witch, but I'm not sure what she meant by that. So,
That was a good fucking movie.
oh, great. If
It's
anything,
not rewatchable though. I've tried.
to me it is.
Once you see the end, and then
The end creeps me out when he is in the corner of the damn basement, the last guy before the girl gets killed, before Heather gets killed, and he's just in the corner. Creeps me out. That scene and when they're in the tent and they didn't know that was going to happen. And that's what I loved about the film. They didn't they weren't working off a script really. And to me that movie was marketed so well. It was
It
the
was the
internet was
first
still
internet advertised movie, because you could watch the found footage, their
yes.
trailer
They
online.
even
It took you
had like
25 minutes, but you could watch it over AOL.
and they even had like no, that was Independence Day, never mind. Or they might have had like a TV special that sounded like a investigative report. But yeah, I mean 1999, that was the most successful independent film since Halloween. You know, and I still it's still I mean it's not like my top 10, but it's there. There was another one made for the Jersey Devil. But it got overshadowed because of Blair Witch called The Last Broadcast and it went straight to
I
DVD.
heard about that.
But I mean that would be cool. Like stuff like that. You have that. You have the Bell Witch Haunting, which I would love to go to that cave. It's out in Tennessee. But yeah, you don't hear, there's nothing. We're like, there's no more serial killers that we know of right now.
Yeah, there's
Like, they
some.
died.
We just don't know
Yeah,
about
we
them.
don't know about them. They died out. I mean, the last one was Jeffrey Dahmer, you know? But like, where are all the great hauntings? Where I want an Amityville horror haunting. I think the most recent one was that one that Zach Bagans went to. Was that the Demon House or
Oh,
something? Yeah. What did Shelley
All right, so
say?
she says there's no mic on radio. Supposedly, there's no way anyone can hear you through them. So, how am I getting direct answers? Also, when I ask them to say bad words and they say them, hard to imagine someone being explicit on the radio.
Well, yet, Howard Stern explicit on the radio.
Yeah, but
We
it,
need Shelly to come on and talk about her
yeah,
experiences.
for real. When are we doing
Come
that,
on,
Shelley?
Shelly. Come on, Shelly.
I can send you
Here's
an
the
invite
invite.
right now.
Yeah, come on. Come on, Shelly.
I'll be the chicken shit. All right, so I did find, like, so you think ghost, a lot of people.
Oh, we're not saying you're. I'm not saying you're faking,
I'm not
but.
saying you're faking either, but I'm saying people hear what they want to hear too.
Yeah, I think when Bagan says this is what they said, your mind thinks that's what they said
Right.
after he, yeah.
But hey, she might be fine and shit. I listen, I am not an expert. Well, I kind of am an
You
expert
are a
in the
demon hunter,
field,
yeah,
but
you are, yeah.
these are the things that just don't make sense to me. And why
Yeah.
are cemeteries so haunted?
That's what he's out. That's fine. I'm sorry, say that again.
I'm eating pizza in my bed with my son.
That's a Friday night right there.
Oh. Wow. All right. So back to the.
So you're saying something about cemeteries?
Yeah, why are they haunted?
Well, because that's where
No,
the
your
dead
spirit's
bodies are.
released way before you're fucking moved to the cemetery. Do you remember reading about that study that doctor did in the 1800s where he was trying to find evidence of a soul. Like people having souls.
No, I don't think I remember this one.
What he did was he found a bunch of people that were about to die.
Okay.
So he put them on a scale. And as they died, like the instant the last breath left, they would lose 7 grams. And that he did that like multiple times. It had multiple, it was all 7 grams.
Yeah, but when you breathe in, I don't know, you're on a scale, it's gonna have more weight. And then when you breathe out, of course you're going to lose weight because you're exhaling. You're letting the
But
pressure
not
out.
7 grams.
Well, how much is what's 7 grams converted to weight?
I don't know.
I'm not good at math and conversions.
My God, you're killing me. Let's see. It's 0.1 pounds. So no, that's not breath.
If I took a deep, well, I mean, if I took a deep
It's not
breath
gonna add
in,
a pound, do you?
I think it would. I'm gonna do it right after we get off. I'm gonna get on the scale and
All
I'm
right,
gonna
well, we're gonna
say,
test this.
I think cemeteries are a lame place. Landmark.
Yeah, but wouldn't it be make more sense to stay in the house that you died in and see the people that you wanted to visit? I
Well,
mean,
then why do they? Okay. So getting back to cemeteries on All Hallows Eve, that's like the one night the dead can rise, or whether the spirits can rise and roam the earth,
I don't know, man. I don't get I don't believe the cemetery thing.
Okay.
They're beautiful. I love them. I
You
wish
know what
I
I
had
would
my
love to
camera on the
do?
way home because it was fog filled.
I would love just to go to Gettysburg and sit on the battlefield and then just relax and let my mind just at ease to hear sounds of gunfire or people fighting each other, that would be badass.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't believe in it?
No, Gettysburg's definitely haunted. All right,
Yeah.
so do you? All right, I think the other reason is a hell of a multitasking thing, no pun. Maybe. Shelly's got her tootsies out, so she's not coming on the podcast.
And not like she would need her to show. I mean, you can just get on your phone and be like this.
Hey, we can only peer pressure so much.
Yeah.
Orbs. Do you believe in orbs?
Yes, but I mean, I do. I mean,
Why? It's all dust.
not, but yeah, but
It is.
I've seen videos where they don't look like dust and
I
they're
can
not
make that with
bones.
a fucking camera. It's all dust.
Yeah, but I took a picture with Irene in Williamsburg in front of a building that's supposedly haunted.
Everything in Williamsburg's fucking haunted. It's
And
400 years old.
there was a lot of
Yeah,
particles on that
dust.
boat.
Because the
Nah.
building's fucking 700 years old.
We
There's
were
dust
inside
everywhere.
the building. We were outside
There's dust
the
outside, believe it or not.
building.
The orbs are the last thing. Like, I will believe EMPs, EVPs way before the fucking dust on a lens tells me ghost.
So, what about ectoplasm?
I haven't seen any. Who's seen some? Who's got some for me to look at?
Right.
That's my skeptic about it. Like, again, I believe in this shit. I have so much that I took a fucking course on this shit. I've seen it, I've smelt it, I've fucking almost touched it, but a lot of the shit people bring out of the woodwork just doesn't make sense. You know, the oldest documented ghost was 3,500 years ago.
Really? We're at
From
like
all
in
over the country. This one was a researcher at a British museum discovered what is believed to be the oldest ghost drawing in the world.
oh,
The
Jerusalem.
findings come in the form of an ancient Babylonian tablet that dates back 3,500 years, which was inscribed with directions on how to perform an exorcism or unwanted spirits.
Oh, wow. The Jewish cemetery behind. Shelly, I think you need to come on a future episode, if not tonight.
Yeah, she's too busy with her tussies.
Yeah.
I
And probably enjoying that pizza too.
had pizza tonight and I tore that shit up. I was starving.
I had buffalo chicken tenders.
Not a bad way. Not a bad way.
No, they were really good too, from a local pizza place called The Pizza Joint.
It's a pizza joint. I like it.
They have a really good margarita pizza too. Holy margarita vodka.
Not a
No, I'm sorry,
huge.
vodka. But I'm sorry, not margarita. It's a vodka sauce pizza.
I'm
Man,
not
is that
big on
good?
vodka sauce.
No,
No.
man, that's good with
I think it's my
mozzarella.
heartburn that fucks me up. Like, it
Okay.
tastes good, but I'd rather a nice
You know what? You know what
marinara.
fucked me up today? I was hungry, so I had free delivery from McDonald's, and I haven't had McDonald's sandwiches in I couldn't tell you how long.
Wow, good for you.
Yeah, and it was I was brave and did a steak, egg, bacon, cheese McMuffin.
I like
Holy.
sometimes they're really good, other times a little chewy.
I actually had the craving for the hash browns. Why I ordered is I love McDonald's hash browns.
That's it. Jared's DMs is going to get blasted with spirit box videos.
Yeah.
Are they shot on a potato or can I actually like see?
So you don't believe in orbs at
No,
all?
not one bit.
I don't know. I
Every
believe.
time I see an orb or someone recorded an orb, it's a fucking piece of dust.
What about shadow people? Do you think it's just like your eyes playing tricks on you?
No, because I've seen a lot of shadows.
Nope, St. John's, Michigan's in the house. What's up, St. John's, Michigan?
I heard he's
Or
competing
St.
with Rick for some cosplay contest on the whole
Oh,
damn
yeah?
enchilada. Yeah.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I caught the end of Rick's podcast last night, and he had a good turnout, and like they
Yeah,
stayed like the
you
whole
guys are having
time.
fun. I was recording for us, or I mean for Haunts, or I would have. Why would you need to see? Ha 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 ha. See? More of my proof. More of my proof. Let's shoot this on a fucking 1920 cell phone and.
Even like I would love to like just go to Eastern State at night and just see if I can see anything, you know.
Oh, yeah. I gotta
Oh yeah,
root for Rick, but good luck.
were they both going to a horror convention or
Yeah, I think
something?
so.
Oh, that's cool.
Somewhere with
Nice.
a cosplay
Okay.
contest. That's the word I'm looking
Well,
for.
good luck to the both of you. And I think St. John's is getting an upgrade. I think J3 is getting him some updated clothing too.
Oh, snappy, snappy. Yeah, Rick had his mask on when they were doing the Jason 3 review.
I missed that
Yeah,
part.
it looked good.
Speaking of that, we'll get back to that Jason at the end. I wanted to bring something up about Trick or Treat Studios. So, but before when we end it all, because they
Dude,
have the
we're
new.
free balling right now. Go ahead, bring it up.
Okay,
We could go back to
have you
Ghost.
seen the they've got I guess they got the license for Friday 13th, so they got a line of hockey mask.
Oh, did they?
And yeah, it's the same mold, but like just different like color schemes. It's not painted, so basically it's like for you to paint if you want.
Oh, that's
And
cool.
then yeah, and then they got they're calling the part three hood like the hillbilly mask or something like that. While it looks the hood looks decent, and people are like, oh yeah, I'm gonna buy this. I mean, for the this is just my opinion. If you're just
Shelly,
a
we are not thinking you're faking. I'm messing with you. It's okay. I've watched a lot of them. I've watched your lives too, remember?
I still like you, Shelly. I'm not like, talking shit on you.
Wow. All right, so trick or
So
treat.
anyway, so for people who were cosplaying, for the casual cosplayer, this hood would be sufficient, but it's production made. So be careful, especially how much money you're spending. If the Michael Myers mask costs about $70, I can only imagine how much this hood might cost. If you want a decent hood that's going to last you longer, you want to go with someone who makes them each by hand, not in a factory. And that could be J3 Jason Costumes or Topher at a New Kind of Fear Customs. That's where I get all my hoods from. They will last you a long time. Just beware of the Trick or Treat Studio stuff.
They're mass produced. Anything mass produced is gonna be where.
Yeah.
The guy who made my Freddy glove made the Phantasm ball for them.
Oh, nice. Okay.
He designed that, so they're gonna mass produce that for him.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Let's see what t-shirts they
That would
do.
be cool to have like on like some type of a stand, and just
Oh, he had one
have somebody.
floating.
Did he?
He made
He had like a
one,
magnet or something?
yeah, it
Or
had said Phantasm in metal and the ball just floated up there. I told him he
that's
needs to
cool.
learn how to get a Freddy glove to float up there.
That'd be cool.
We need more floating shit.
Yeah.
All right, so we've got going back 3,500 years to exorcisms. That's crazy. Then you got the Salem witch trials, which was, a bunch of women on their period, and we murdered them for witchcraft.
Yeah, I know.
It's, I don't know, like I love ghost stories. They're my favorite kind of horror movie is the paranormal. All the hauntings, I've watched all of them. I grew up on poltergeist. But like, it's not that I don't believe people. I'm just like, I want more evidence. Sparty says on February 8th, St. John, Michigan, Jason will be doing an interview and custom live stream. Please check it out. 7 p.m. February 8th. Yeah, well.
Where we can check it out? You need to let us know. And how are you gonna be doing an interview in costume? Jason doesn't talk. No, I'm just kidding.
You did an
Continue.
interview in costume, dickhead.
I did? Well, I didn't talk,
No.
did I?
I was like, wait a minute, we fucking filmed one.
Yeah.
That was a fun night.
That was, man, I can't wait to the next Friday, 13th in October, which is not until I think 2028.
Oh,
So Brian,
Jesus.
please invite me out.
He's gonna be retired by then.
You think so?
Yeah, I'm gonna talk him into joining me.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, that was a great night. I was tired at the end of that night, like sore,
Man,
but
I
yeah,
wish you
that
got
was.
some of that trip because that trip was to die for. I don't want to go
Yeah.
back. I wonder what kind of food they're gonna have at Laurel's.
Well, I'm excited for like, when you do like the press night for Field of Screams, and
Yeah.
hopefully you can go back to Reaper's Revenge for that new attraction.
Reapers, I might be doing a little differently this year.
Oh yeah.
I might be hopping on the Terror Tour
Oh, really?
because I think they're going a day earlier. And
Okay.
they're hitting like four haunts.
Oh
So for the
wow.
price, it's just easier for me to do that.
How much is that?
Last year they charged 270, but I think they went to like five haunts.
In one day?
No, it was over the weekend.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
You're right. That's why you use cure cards. It will be Scarecraft Studios.
Okay, I'll look it up.
Very cool.
Awesome. So, how does it like a company will book these with the different haunts?
Yeah.
That's
And
cool. Okay.
they get a swag bag, you take the bus. You could drive
Oh,
yourself if you
so it's
want.
sort of like when you go to AAA and do like a bus tour, kind of.
Yeah, same principle.
Okay.
And then you're first in, first out, especially
That's
if you're,
cool.
and then a lot of times you're fed, so it, to me the money might be right for the five piece. And you want to come, me and I'm making Shelly do this. We're doing four in one night. You coming?
Well,
Or in one
Shelly,
night.
I mean, I hope you do come out to one I'm coming to, and
No, I'm asking you. You want to do the four in one
me?
night? Yeah.
Four in one night. If I can afford it, yeah.
Yeah, that's what
You
I'm
know?
worried about. But
Yeah.
yeah, it's four. It's Waldorf, Hotel of Horror, Devil's Last Laugh,
Where's
and
that?
Halls of
Where's
Horror.
Devil's Last Laugh?
Lee Heighton.
Oh, so it's in the same area
Oh,
as
they're all
Waldorf.
within 10 miles.
I did send your inf the info to Halloween or Halloween Haunts to my friend John, who he does security at the Hotel of Horror, and he was going to pass it along to the owner and some other of the haunt actors.
Shelly goes, how do I join this live? It's not a live.
Jared has to send you a link on
And
Zoom.
then I gotta do stuff. We were just kidding. We'll set you up for an interview though.
Yeah, come on. Looking at this, I'll look at the schedule, but it'll probably be like end of February, beginning of March, so I'll give you enough time to get ready.
You put your tootsies away. Yeah, we're wrapping up anyway. We're hitting that hour mark.
Yeah,
I was looking at
it
StreamYard. They're pricey.
StreamYard. Oh, are they?
Yeah.
It seems like everyone's doing that now.
They are. It's easy. And it's easier to bring people in. But it was like $30. And
Oh
then that was
my.
just like 720p, not even like 1080p.
Oh,
If she clipped her
yeah.
nails. Okay, that's good. At least she did that. Yeah, I only pay like 17 for Zoom, so.
Yeah, that's what I was paying when I
Plus,
was
this looks a
doing.
little cleaner, so.
It does. And watching the StreamYard, it doesn't look as clear as like you're like what how you're doing it.
Yeah.
And if it doesn't support current technology, then there's no
Oh,
point
it can.
in.
You just gotta pay for it.
Yeah, well, no.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're ballers on a budget.
That's right. Nickels. Nickels in the club. Nickels in the club. All right, so what else is here?
So, Shelly, I want you to come out to NJ HorrorCon in April. Does she live in Jersey or PA?
She lives in Delaware.
Oh, damn, I didn't know that. Never mind then.
I
Well, come out anyway. Or come out to I Heart Horror, February
heart
10th.
her, Sayreville, New Jersey.
Yeah, your boy Father Evil will be there.
Yeah, he married me.
Yeah. And what is he called, Terry?
Jenny.
Lady? Jenny. Jenny.
So now to Dino and the rest of my friends, she will forever be Jenny. Little does he
Nice.
know. Oh, every day. What's Jenny say about the Cowboys? What's Jenny da, 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 da. I'm like, that's so funny. Brian, you're
I'm
gonna
gonna
miss a
miss
fellow
you.
Jason at Penhurst February 9th. Jared sold out. Oh, Shelly, yeah, we're not heading there. We committed to Laurel's House of Horror for Valentine's Day. So I'm gonna meet those guys and have a good time there. But yeah, I mean, it's interesting to have all three open, but their price tag's still crazy for an off-season event for me. Yeah, how much do they want here? Let's see. They do have all three haunts open, which is pretty awesome.
Okay. Can't get two Jersey people right quick.
Yeah, she could.
Well,
She's in a cool spot. All right, let's see.
we're gonna have to meet up sometime, Shelly.
Yes. All right, let's see. Haunted attraction, fall date hours, buy tickets. Let's see. Penhurst is Shelly's favorite. She loves this place. She does all her That's not bad.
I've always wanted
$49
to
for
go to
all
Penhurst.
three.
That's not bad, no.
$75 for VIP, but you get a bunch of shit for VIP. Oh, they sold out Saturday. Oh, a
That's
couple
cool.
time slots. So they got room. Yeah, man. So like I just wanted to have a conversation about ghosts. Some things have been bothering me about it. Yeah, I don't believe in orbs at all. And they have a speakeasy for the first time and the off season haunt is a
That's cool.
first time. It is a first time. And I was happy to hear them do it. It'd be interesting to see what they do. They probably won't do halfway to Halloween because they have that Paracon, whatever a Paracon is. That's, I guess, the convention for
For
Ghostbusters.
paranormal. Yeah.
Who's the biggest liar? And I believe, I do, and I believe Shelley is, you know, she's not out there trying to make fucking millions off of it, off her research.
Right, right. It's the little, I don't want to call them little people, but the, you know, you have the Zach Baggins of the world, but then you have the ones who are in it for the truth, not the money. That's what Shelley is. Yeah.
Yeah. She says 75 apiece for a whole date night is right. Yeah, it's not bad. I mean, wish they had like a dinner they give you too. But I mean, they have the three free drinks you get and stuff. So yeah, I mean, it's worth it. They did a good thing. They're filling up. Hopefully they sell out so they open more off season. Because Penrith is tough to get to in the season. I'm not gonna fucking lie.
Is
those lines are incredibly long.
I just want to go to Penrith off season for a tour.
You can do that. I think they want. Yeah. I was just on the website. They want.
Were you?
They want 100 to do a paranormal tour.
I said I don't even want to do a paranormal. I just want to do a regular.
I don't even know if they do the daytimes anymore. They might.
Oh really?
Shelly, they still do. Here I go with the hiccups every fucking time I record. Shelly, they still do the daytime tour where you just like walk around.
When I worked for the Arc, one of our individuals that we supported, she came from Penrith.
Oh.
Yeah, I bet she had stories. You know,
I bet she did.
Yeah.
Some crazy stories.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if Shelly gets back to us real quick. This has been a fun episode. We kind of turned that cancellation into something.
Yeah, it's good. When we don't have notes and stuff, it's more organic.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
Daytime's tour start again in spring.
Oh, that's cool.
What if I want to go in the snow? It's probably pretty as shit in the snow.
Oh, I bet it is. But it's creepy looking too at night. You know, I love when it snows and it just seems so brighter at night, you know? I bet that place looks eerie.
I was so pissed, man. I really should have just stopped being lazy and grabbed my camera. We had a fog layer here because it's warm and all the snow melting. And we have that lake that looks like Crystal Lake with the fog rolling over.
That would have been great. You know?
I know.
And then superimpose me in front of the
lake. I got the green screen coming.
Yeah, nice.
Paracon is a pretty big event, but lots of people and kind of pricey. And a lot of lies, too. But I'm sure they sell pretty cool shit there, too, though.
But yeah. Probably get an EVP.
I got ears.
And your spirit box.
Follow the solid employees. You'll see the pretty snow pics.
Also, okay.
Yeah, right. I don't know if I follow anyone from Henhurst but the owner. All right, let's wrap this up, though, bro. We got movies to watch. You got to go to bed. It's past 8.
It is.
You got to watch 10 minutes of Barbie before blacking out.
Yes, get my 10 minutes in of Barbie and girl power and fall asleep.
Hey, girl power.
Yes.
All right, brother. This has been the Horror Chef Podcast. We come out every Monday. Make sure you like, subscribe if you like listening to us argue about ghosts and other stuff like true crime, paranormal, movies, and whatever the hell we feel like dealing with that day. We'll see you guys next Monday. Halloween Haunts 365 Productions.